Friends, welcome back to my channel. When we see a half bridge circuit switch mode power supply, we see a capacitor here which I connected with the oscilloscope, and we find some voltage drop across this capacitor. It is called series coupling capacitor. How we can calculate it? First of all, we will see its calculation and then we will analyze it practically. And we will see the practical example of this power supply. It is 12 volt 25 ampere. We can say it is 300 watt. Any power supply which is using two capacitors, series capacitors, DC capacitors and DC rail, and there is a one capacitor which is connected in series with the transformer winding. It is called series coupling capacitor. Basically, it is used to switch these capacitors one by one. When this MOSFET will switch, at that time the positive voltage from this MOSFET will move to the winding and it will give a pulsed voltage to the winding. When this MOSFET will switch, at that time the negative circle from here will complete to the positive pole of this capacitor. So bipolar current will move in this winding. It is a 28 kilohertz power supply. Let's check the calculation. For example, this power supply, it is 12 volt 25 ampere. So P out is 12 25 300 watt. V in 220 volt. We can say plus minus 20%. 264 volt maximum upper volt, it will 176 volt. So we can say the line input can vary from 176 to 264 volt. So let's calculate 176 multiply with 1.414 to check. The DC rail will minimum 248 volt. At each capacitor divided by 2, 124 volt. The minimum voltage here at each capacitor. Let's check for upper range. 264 multiply with 1.414, 373 volt divided by 2, 186 volt. Switching frequency for this power supply, it is F switching, it is 28 kilohertz. Because it is half bridge topology, so 28 kilohertz will divide it into two portions, this one and this one. So maximum duty cycle will allowed for each MOSFET will 45% maximum. Dmax 0 to 45% in push-pull stage. Let's calculate the value of this capacitor. To calculate this capacitor, we have very simple formula. C coupling, coupling capacitor value. How much is the current? I peak, I primary peak. DT, how much time will allow to charge the capacitor? This is the time allowed for this capacitor. What is the voltage level? Charging voltage. Delta T, delta VC. Three variables we need to calculate it. First of all, we will calculate the I peak primary. I primary peak. We know the wattage rate 300 watt. This is the maximum power out. So we will consider 300 watt as output, 300 watt as input. If you want to take exact 300 watt, so you have to at the losses here. So 300 watt divided by at which voltage level we need 300 watt? 124 volts from this switch. V in minimum 300 divided by 124 volts, it is 2.41 ampere. This is a theoretical value. For practical designing, operate this value with 1.3 to 1.5. for exact and perfect output, let's operate it with 1.4, 2.4, 1 multiply with 1.4, 3.38 amperes. This is the maximum peak primary current for one switching MOSFET. At 28 kilohertz, we need bidirectional current from both MOSFETs. We can say in 45% duty cycle, we need this current. So we will consider that this MOSFET will switch and it will create apparent power equal to the output power. This is our first variable. The second variable, time. How much time will allow to charge this capacitor? We know frequency is 28 kilohertz. We want to know the time. Time is 1 over f. F is 28 kilohertz. It is 3.57 10 raised to power minus 5 second. Now, how much time out of this time will allow to turn on one MOSFET? It is 45%. Multiply it 45% with this one. So maximum time 1.6071 10 raised to power minus 5 second. So this is the time which will allow to charge this capacitor. Then we have the third variable here, VC, charging voltage. This is the current, this is the time, how much voltage we will allow for this capacitor. We have winding, we have capacitor. This end is connected to, we can say, the center point of the capacitors. This have XC, this one XL, two resistors in series. It have its impedance, it have its impedance. At that time, when we will calculate the current, we will need to use the minimum voltage, that is 124 volt, which we calculated with the line drop. But when we will calculate the capacitor, we will use the maximum voltage, that are 186 volt. So we in maximum, these are the maximum voltage, 186 volts. Out of 186 volt, how much voltage we will allow to charge? There are two different approaches. You can allow 10%, you can allow 20%. If you take 10%, the maximum voltage for this capacitor, that is 18.6 volt. We will allow 18.6 volt to drop across this capacitor with this current at this time. And if we will select 20%, at that time it will come 37.2 volt. That are too high. Okay, we will select 30 volt. For example, it is a best practice to select some marginal value. If we will select 10%, that will very tight calculation, but now we are taking 30 volt. Allowed charge, allowed charging voltage, V in maximum, take 10%, 20%. It is 186 volt, 10% is 18.6 volt and 37.2 volt. These are the allowed voltage for the capacitor. Let's put these values in the formula and then we will check it. I peak primary, that is 3.38 ampere. And time is 1.6071 10 raised to power minus 5, and the voltage we allow, maximum charging voltage 30 volt. That are too much, but it will good to select a best capacitor for our calculation. So it is 1.810 10 raised to power minus 6. Okay, let's check the minimum voltage. If we will select 18 volt, minimum voltage 18 volt, at that time we will need 3 microfarad capacitor, that is too large, but it will reduce the power losses. We have to consider two things. If we will use the high value capacitor, 3 microfarad capacitor, maybe we need 2 or more. And if we allow some more voltage, 30 volt, at that time the capacitor size will reduce. So this is our calculated value for the capacitor. Let's check the available ceramic capacitor. Now if we see the practical value, we need 1.8 microfarad, and in the capacitor chart here is 1.5. we cannot select 1.5, we can select 2 microfarad or the next closer value, that is 2.2. we can select any of these two capacitors. So if we select 2 microfarad, okay, let's suppose 2 10 raised to power minus 6, that is 205 code, or we can select 2.2 10 raised to power minus 6, that is 225 code. How much voltage drop across this capacitor? Now we select this capacitor and this capacitor. Voltage at maximum current, we can say the maximum current at the low line drop, that is 3.38 ampere. And the time will 1.607 10 raised to power minus 5, and the capacitor value will 2 10 raised to power minus 6. Let's check the voltage. Divided 1.607 divided by with 2 10 raised to power minus 6, it will up to 27 volt. That is the maximum voltage at maximum current at low line drop. And if we put 2.2 microfarad, that will drop 24 volt. This one will drop 27 volt, and it will drop 24 volt. So we can select this one, because when it will drop minimum voltage, it will dissipate less power. This is the worst case scenario. For example, if you consider 2 ampere current at maximum voltage, when the line is 220 volt, the maximum voltage will drop this one. When the line voltage are 220 volts, we can say the maximum current will flow 2 ampere. We can consider here. Let's check practically. This time I have 230 volt, multiply it 1.414 divided with 2 162 volt. We have 300 watts. We have 300 watts divided 162 volt, 1.85 ampere. The maximum primary current for one transistor, one MOSFET, will 1.85 ampere. Now let's calculate with this one. We will consider 2 ampere, multiply it 1.607 10 raised to power minus 5 divided with 2.2 10 raised to power minus 6. So 14 volt, that is excellent. So maximum 14 volt will drop at full load. Let's check practically. Here it is using 2.2 microfarad capacitor, and now I am connecting 150 watt load, half load. So let's check the voltage drop across this capacitor. The maximum 7.2, 7.2 divided with 2, we can say it is dropping 3.5 volt. So 3.5 volts this time this capacitor is dropping just only 3.5 volt for each cycle, total 7 volts across this capacitor. From here to here 7 volts for one cycle. We calculated for one cycle 3.5 volts. As we calculated for 230 volts, the maximum voltage at full load, that will 14 volts. When the current is 2 ampere, the maximum allowed voltage are 14 volts. This time, it is dropping 3.5 volts at half load. That's nice. We can say it is working nicely. What we need now, which type of capacitor will calculate it with low ESR? Metallized capacitor must be nonpolar, and it must film capacitor, and it must sustain the maximum current, as it is using in this 300 watt power supply, it is using 225J. What is the voltage value for this capacitor? As we discussed, we allowed maximum 30 volt. So we can select 50 volt, 100 volt. But for best practice, we must select 400 volt. That is for safety. That is a good practice. So otherwise, if we select some high ESR value, it will dissipate more heat. We must select low ESR value capacitor, metal film capacitor, metal plus film capacitor, and it must be nonpolar. And it must sustain maximum primary current. So it will work long life and it will dissipate less heat. I hope so. This video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching.